Hi, in this video I'm going to discuss algorithms, how we can use the variables and what kind of rules that we have to use with variables. So if you have didn't watch the first algorithm lesson, just go to that and find out what we have done with that. So here mainly we are going to discuss about Python variables. So we are moving to the Python lesson. So because of that, you have to know how you have to create a variable, design a variable. When you are designing a variable, what kind of rules that you have to think about. So because we are going to follow the Python, use the same rules. Now here they have mentioned variable names are case sensitive. Variable names are case sensitive. So that means capital F, capital N name, simple F, simple name, capital F, simple name, simple F, capital name are different variable names. So you can use the variable names. It has to be meaningful. More than using FN, you can use first name or F name or something meaningful. But in here the variables are case sensitive. Okay, so these things are identified differently in the memory and the CPU. Variable names must begin with a letter or underscore. So when you are starting a variable, you have to use a alphabet letter, simple or capital letter, and you can follow with other digits. Or you can start with an underscore. So you can see F7, it's a valid variable name. Underscore 1, it's a very valid variable name. Underscore name, that is a valid variable name. So you can start with a letter or you can use a underscore. You can't start with special characters like comma, address, hash, like here what we have used. Okay, then a variable name can only contain alphanumeric characters and underscore, such as A to Z, simple A to Z, capital A to Z, 0 to 9 and underscore. So these are the only things that can include in a variable. Use meaningful variable names, as I said before. And can't use special characters, at, hash, dollar mark, percentage for the variable names. A variable name cannot contain space. So you can't give F space name. You can't give first space name. So you can't use spaces within the variable names. If you want a space, you can use an underscore something to separate this one. Okay, reserve words. In Python, many reserve words are there, like if is a reserve word, while is a reserve word, print is a reserve word. So don't use reserved words in Python. Okay, we'll move to the next slide. Now here, as I said in the first slide, we have discussed about the sequence. So here the sequence is there, step by step procedure. Okay, the steps are executing one after the other, one after the other. Okay, right. So there are three basic control structures. So the second one will be selection, conditional. So what is conditional? If the condition is satisfied, you have to do one set of instructions, otherwise you have to do another set of instructions. Then third one, repetition means while a given condition is satisfied, you have to do the given set of instruction again and again. Okay, while a given condition is satisfied, you have to do the same instruction set again and again. We'll go to the next slide. So here with a small diagram I have showed it. A sequence is a series of statements that are executed one after the another. Okay, statements are there. So think you are having some objects. So when you are moving on the road, you have to pass this object, then only you are moving to the next object, you are passing and going one after the other. Okay, now here selection, the conditional control structure execute different statements depending on the certain condition. A According to the condition, it will take the necessary action. If the condition is satisfied, it will do one set of statements. If it is not satisfied, it has to do another set of instructions. So here you have a road. If you want to go to right side, so if it is right, you can move to there. If it is false, you are going to other way. Okay. And the repetition. So in the repetition, what will happen? Till a condition is satisfied, while a given certain condition satisfied, what will do? You are repeating the same instruction set. You are checking the statements and executing the statements, and again going back to the condition, checking the condition. If it is true, again doing the statements, again checking the condition. So like that, it will repeat the condition till the given condition false. Okay, if the condition is false, it will move out of the instruction set and follow the next instructions. So here basically we are going to discuss about questions: input unit price, okay, unit price. If it is unit price greater than 200, you have to give 20% discount. Okay, first question. And the second question, they have given input two numbers and display the bigger number. Okay, N1 and N2, bigger number. Third one, they are asking to input the subject mark and display the weight. Marks greater than 50, pass, otherwise fail. Okay, so these are the three questions that we are going to discuss with the selection. Okay, we will move to our video. I'll use the whiteboard now to explain this. Okay, so on the first question, they have given to input the unit price. Okay, you have to input the unit price, and okay, so how, as we have discussed the formats, use the same formats. Start, you have to input unit price. Okay, UP stands for unit price. Okay, unit price. Then you have input the unit price. Now you are checking if unit price greater than 200, then. Okay, so here you are using the condition: if the given unit price is greater than 200 rupees, then what you will have to do? You have to calculate the discount. I'll take D as the variable. D is what? Discount. D is discount. Okay. So if the unit price is greater than 200, you have to calculate the discount. How? Unit price into 20%. Unit price into 20%, and they are asking to display the unit price. So if the condition is there, if the unit price is greater than 200 only, you are giving the discount, then the discount will be this amount. Otherwise, else, what will be the discount? There's no discount. There's no discount. D is equal to 0. Then, and if. Okay, can you understand? Now you have input the unit price, you have calculated the discount. How? If the unit price is greater than 200, then the discount, how you can calculate? Unit price into 20%. Okay, why? They have mentioned from the unit price, 20% discount you have to give. Otherwise, no discount. If it is less than, if it is 200 or less than that, there's no discount. So D is equal to 0. Okay? Then finally, they are asking to display discount and start stop. So you can see the basic concepts that we have used. Start and stop in the same line, and here we have indented. If you are using the if condition, what will happen? Whatever the instruction that you are following inside the if condition, again indenting. Indent. You have used some space. And the else is same line. Why? The if, for if, the relevant else will be on the same line. Then, inside the else, I have given some indent and D equal 0. End if and display the discount and stop. Now we'll use the trace table. Trace table. Now with the help of trace table, what you are going to do? You are going to check the given code is, whatever the pseudo code that you have written is correct with the help of some test data. Okay? Input UP. What is UP? Unit price. So you have input unit price. So you can input the unit price 150. Okay, 150. If unit price greater than 200. Unit price greater than 200. Is this satisfied? Unit price greater than 200? False. So what will happen? It will move to the else part. It will move to the else part. Else, another variable d is equals to 0. D is equal to 0. Now, end if, you are coming out of the if condition, display D. Now, the input-output devices will search for the result. Now, the output has to display as the value that is representing with D. So, what will happen? It will forward discount will be 0 and stop. That is all about that program. Okay, right? Now think, the user has input 400 rupees as the unit price, 400. Now what will happen? The unit price greater than 200? Yes, satisfied. True. Okay, now what will happen? It will come to this location. D is equal unit price into 20%. D, the variable. Now the discount will be 80 rupees. With the help of the CPU, arithmetic and logic unit perform the calculation. So now, the memory location D contains the value 80. Now you are coming out of the if condition. After you come out, there is another step. Display D. Now it will display on the screen the discount as 80 rupees. Can you all understand? So with the help of the trace table, you can find out with the values, whatever the code that you have given is correct. That means you can test that. We'll move to the next one. Whatever the notes that you required, just write down. Here I have given all the codes. Just look the codes and try to understand these things. And write down all the things that is necessary. Okay? Right. We'll move to the next one. In this question, they are asking to input two numbers and display the bigger number. Okay, display the bigger number. So I have input two values, N1 and N2. If N1 greater than N2, so now here I have given start input N1, N2, so two numbers I have inputted. I am checking N1 is greater than N2. Whatever the value that you have given in N1 is greater than N2. Then I have taken a variable called large equal N1, else large equal N2. End if and display large. So large means the variable that I have taken. You can take any value, x, y, or whatever the variable that you require according to that rules that I have given in the previous slide. Now with the trace table, we will check this one. Now I have taken the first test data. I have taken 5 and 9. So you have input for N1 5 and N2 9. Okay. Now you are coming to the condition. Is N1 greater than N2? N1 greater than N2? 5 greater than 9? False. So what will happen? You are moving to the else part. In the else, what will happen? There is a variable called large. And that large variable is equal to N2. And what is N2? 9. Now what will happen? You are coming out of the if condition. When you come out, there is a instruction, display the large. Display large. Display large means what? From the output device, it will search for large. Now large is 9, it will display on the screen as 9. So 9 will be the output. Okay, so we'll take another test data, 20 and 5. Okay, so the user has input 20 and 5. Now coming to the next step, if now the selection N1 greater than N2, 20 greater than 5, yes. So it will give the boolean values, true or false, two values, false or true. Now here, 20 greater than 5, true. Then what will happen? Inside that, large equal N1. Now large will be N1, N1 is 20, so large will be 20. You are coming out of the if condition, display large. So now what will happen? On the screen it will display 20 as the output. Okay, so write down this instruction set. Okay, whatever the pseudo code that is relevant to that question, second question. For the third question, they are asking input the subject mark. Okay, so you have to input the subject marks. If the marks greater than 50, display pass, otherwise display fail. Okay, so this is required by a teacher to find the grade. just go through the code and try to find out what is the format that I have written. Start and stop on the same line. And the instruction said, if you are using the selection if condition, the instruction within the if condition, that is also indented. Okay. Input SM. SM means what? Subject marks. Okay. That's a variable name. SM I have used. Meaningful and short form. So you are checking if SM is greater than 50. Then, if the subject mark is greater than 50, then what will happen? I'm using a variable called grade and I'm assigning the value pass. Okay? If it is not satisfied, you are coming to the else part, the grade will be fail. So here, this is not a number. This is not an integer number or float number, decimal number with a decimal point. So this is a string text. So because of that, I have used single quotations here, single quotations. Pass, that is a string or text. So because of that, you are using within the single quotations or double quotations. Okay, grade equal fail, that is a string. Again, you are using single quotation or double quotation. Finally, you are displaying the grade. So we'll check with some test data. So you are taking the subject marks as 65. Now you are checking the grade. Is SM greater than 50? True. If it is true, what you will have to do? You have to take a variable called grade. And the variable has the value assigned pass. Okay, then what will happen? It will go to display, display grade. On the screen it will display pass. Now you are inputting 45. So what will happen? It will come to the next instruction. If SM greater than 50, is marks greater than 50? No. 45, it is less than 50. Then what will happen? It will move to the else part. Else part, grade equal fail. Now for the variable grade, it will take the value fail. Then you are coming out of the if condition, display grade. It will be fail. I'll take third data. Now 50. What will happen to 50? If subject mark greater than 50. Greater than 50. It is not mentioned equal 50. So because of that, what will happen? It is less than 50. Okay? It is equal to 50. So the condition will be false. Now it will move to the else part. So the grade will be fair. So when you come out of the while loop, if condition, what will happen? Display grade. So the grade will be displaying as fair. The value under the variable will be displayed. Okay. So these are simple questions relevant to if condition selection. So try to understand these things, and we'll on the next video we'll discuss about the repetition while loop. Thanks.